Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mekala Varshit Reddy. I'm currently pursuing my BTech at Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Dundigal, and my specialization is AIML CSC department. So let us dive into the video. So in this session, we are going to be discussing about a program which is basically finding GCF and LCM, which is basically greatest common factor and lowest common multiple. So let us dive, without further delay, let us dive deep into the video. So before we get started, let us give some introduction about GCF. The GCF stands for greatest common factor, known as highest common factor. GCF is greatest among the factors of a number, the factors that are shared by two or more numbers called common factor. So what is LCM? LCM stands for least common multiple. The LCM is the least common multiple all the common multiplies of two or more number. As we already have, a multiple is the number obtained by multiplying a number by itself or any other number. So methods of finding greatest common factor are listing of factors. In this method, we list the factors of two or more numbers to find common factor from the list. Then we select the greatest among all the common factors. Prime factorization. In this method, we use a factor tree to find the prime factorization of number and list out the common prime factors of numbers. Then the product of all common prime factors in the greatest common factor. Methods of finding LCM or least common multiple. Listing multiples. In this method, we find multipliers of two or more numbers and find out the common multipliers from the list. Then least among all common multipliers is least common multiple in this prime factorization. In this method, we use prime tree to find the prime factorization of numbers. List each different factor where it appears the greatest number of times and multiply them to get least common multiple. Okay, so before I start the program, let us know something about pseudocode. Pseudocode is basically a code which is used for a better understanding when we explain our code to others, or let us say it will be an explanation to in a written format as pseudocode. So in this pseudocode, I am going to be executing the program A and B. So here A is using loops and B is using recursive functions. So before getting into the loops, we all know loops, right? Loops are basically of two types, exit and entry loop. So we can use any of the loop to find greatest common factor. But in my program, I'm gonna use a for loop for this. So let us see the pseudocode for that. In this C program, we are reading the two integer numbers. So here I am reading two integer numbers A and B into the compiler. Compare the two numbers store the greatest number in numerator and smallest number in denominator. So basically, while calculating GCF, I need to know what is the remainder and what is the numerator and what is the denominator. It should be in a proper fraction, right? So I'll take a greatest number in numerator side and smallest number in denominator side. So while we are using here a while loop, but you can also use for loop for better initialization also. But while loop will be a better option in finding GCF. Okay. Run the while loop until the remainder becomes zero. So here is the main key part. So while you're writing your program, executing this program, we may also need a computer and a pen and paper to basically write the steps of it. As you write the steps of the GCF and LCM, let us say I have written the program of GCM. So I'm writing the division of 36 and 28. So I'm basically dividing 28 from 36. I mean 36 from 28. So this becomes 4, obviously, right? So I'm going on dividing the factors until I get the satisfied answer. So that's what the while loop does, right? So inside the while loop, keep on dividing the numerator by denominator and store the value of remainder variable, as he said. Okay. When the value of numerator variable becomes zero, coming out of loop and store the denominator in GCD variable. So if we observe in GCD, write a division format and just say I give 2 and 3. Okay, this is the best example. So 3 will be in numerator and 2 will be in denominator. If I divide with 1, it will say 2 and 1, right? So continue the division until you get 0, like 1 divided by 3, and divide 1 with 3 and you may get the 0 value. But what is in the quotient type? It is 1, so it will be the HCF. So similar to that, let us say I take 28 and 36 as the consideration. So divide 28 and 36. So you may get you may get 8 as its answer. So 8 divided by 28, right? I'm gonna divide it by 3. It will give me like 4. So 4 divided by 8. Here I'm getting a remainder as 0. So my overall answer will be overall HCF will be 4, right? As 4 on 4 being the quotient, it's giving me the 0. I mean the remainder is 0, so I'm getting the answer similar to that. But in compiler, we use, instead of writing the step one by one, I'm using a loop for better execution and also not slop. Rather than a sloppy one, I can use a better efficient code to execute this program. So flowchart. So flowchart is basically a graphical representation of the program which you are being executed. So by observing the flowchart, here I'm taking oval shaped as start and then reading two inputs, num1 and num2, in rhombus, in a parallelogram basically. So when I say n1 equal to num1 and n2 equal to num2, it's basically writing denominator equal to num1 and numerator equal to num2. So you can use if here to write whether to decide your denominator and numerator. So num2 is not equal to 0. Yeah, this is important, right? Num2, if num2 is not equal to 0, I'm saying temp1 equal to num1, num1 is equal to num2, num2 is equal to temp percentile num2. So basically, as I said earlier, the same in the algorithm, the same program will be executed in flowchart. So if I say not equal to 0, then as the loop goes on continuing, there will be a certain point where num2 should be equal to 0. Then it will come out of the loop to execute the next program, which will be LCM. So basically, least common multiplier. So if we say least common multiplier, 2 and 3. Let us take 2 and 3. And 2 has some of the multipliers like 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, etc. And 3 has 0, 3, 6, 9, etc. So what is the least common multiplier in it? Obviously, it will be 3. So we have a formula to calculate LCM, which will be num1 into num2 by GCD. This will give us least common multiplier. For example, 2 into 3 divided by the HCF which I would be getting, which will be obviously 6, right? So yeah, this will be our flowchart here. So yeah, so here is the executed program. Let us take a hash include stdio.h. Here is the hash include is basically documentation declaration. Hash, I'm including a library which will be stdio. This will basically takes input and output library functions from the module. So int main, here I'm not taking any functions, I'm directly executing in loops, right? So int num1 comma num2 is num2 LCM temporary value GCD. So I'm basically assigning some random variables, as you can see. So I'm giving printf statement as please enter two integers. So I'm typing, yeah, here you can see I gave 2 and 3. Okay, so int a equal to num1 and int b equal to num2. So I'm basically giving a is equal to num1 and b is equal to num2. You can basically check this by if also, as I mentioned in the pseudocode, while num2 is not equal to 0, temporary variable is equal to num2. Num2 is equal to num1 by num2. Num1 is equal to temporary. So by doing that, we are storing the remainder in num2, and num1 will be our temporary value now. So the process will keep on be executing until and unless the remainder will be 0. So like that, if the as I mentioned earlier in the while loop, num2 is not equal to 0, right? If the loop will be at 0, it will be coming out of the loop GCD equal to num1, and I will be printing the GCD value. So and LCM, as I said earlier, LCM is equal to A into B by GCD. So by writing 2 into 3 by GCD, which will always which is obviously, so I may get the answer. So let us see input and output for that. Okay, so input of this will be please enter two values, and I'm giving 2 and 3 for that. GCD of 2 and 3 are 1. LCM of 2 and 3 are 6. So you might get a keen idea of how to execute a program by using loops. So let us see how some other ways of solving this program without using loops, right? So as I said earlier, this is the pseudocode using recursive function. The LCM function takes two A and B as an input. It calculates the LCM by A and B and divide it by GCD of two numbers. Finally, we denote the usage of function by finding the GCD and LCM of two numbers, num1 and num2. The GCD function has two numbers, A and B as users. If B is equal to 0, that means A is GCD of two numbers. So we return A. Otherwise, we recursively call GCD function with B as new value A and remainder A divided by B and the new value of B. So by this, you may understand how the recursive function works in terms of GCD and GCD. So here is the flowchart of a recursive function. So yeah, I'm giving basically a start prompt, reading A and B values. I'm basically calling the argument here. So what is the argument here? Yeah, the argument is GCD. So if n into m, if n into m get GCF n m, if n equal to 0, n equal to 0, return to main program, return m. By observing this, you may get a keen idea of a recursive program. So yeah, so here is the program of using recursive functions. So I'm giving hash include stdio.h, which is basically documentation declaration, int hcf, int n1 and int n2, int main, int n1 comma int n2, printf enter two positive integers. So I'm basically taking a print prompt and making the user to prompt n1 and n2 by using scanf function. So I'm basically calling here the function, as you can see, hcf n1 comma n2, right? Int lcm. Okay, so I'm going to now, so talking about this later, let us observe some of them. Int lcm equal to, as I told you, n1 into n2 by hcf of the n1 and n2 and printing them, right? So yeah, and now comes the function part. Int hcf n1 comma int n2, if n2 not equal to 0, return hcf n2 comma n1 percentile n2, else return n1. So this is the total program on how to use recursive functions on GCD and LCM. Enter two positive values. So I'm taking here 2 and 3. GCD of 2 and 3 is 1. LCM of 2 and 3 number is 6. So yeah, this will be our total program. Okay, thank you folks for listening to my lecture. I hope you liked that lecture. Like, share and subscribe. Bye friends.